We'll stand, we'll have our prayer and pledge by Commissioner Oric.
Thank you, good Lord, for this good day and blessings in our life, dear Father. Thank you for what you give us, dear Heavenly Father. Thank you for our children, our families. Heavenly Father, remember the soldiers and the ones that's overseas, dear Jesus, that's fighting for our freedom. Bless each and every one that's here to see, Lord. Watch over us and protect us and keep us clean, Lord, and humble. Thank you for the blessings in our life. I pray, Lord, that you'll give us knowledge and understanding to make the best decisions for our county, dear Heavenly Father, and our communities. Lord, thank you for all that you do. But most of all, I thank you for the plan of salvation. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we're going to take the roll. Everybody's present. Mark, mash your present button, then your confirmed button. Okay. Show us the count, my friend.
Yeah. 12 present, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Ruthford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent.
Okay. This time I'll entertain a motion to approve the minutes of our previous meeting.
Motion to approve the previous minutes.
Second.
Got a motion by Oric, seconded by Wendell Bailey. Any discussion, any questions?
Back to the roll call count, there was 11 present.
Yeah, you're exactly right.
You can understand.
Yeah. Mash your present button, then confirm. Okay. We got 11 present, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Ruthford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Okay, now we're moving on to approval of the previous minutes. We have a motion by Oric, seconded by Wendell Bailey. All those in favor of approval, vote yes. Then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 11 yes, 4 absent. Okay, next order of business is notary public renewals. We have 6 of those: Barbara Davis, Kevin L. Shelley, Linda Daly, Stacy McCulley, Janie Sawinski, Mary Lamb. I'll entertain a motion to approve the notary renewals.
Motion to approve the notary renewals, Mr. Chairman.
Got a motion and seconded by Sue Nance. Any discussion, any questions? All those in favor of approval of the notary renewals,
vote yes, then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Call the vote, Madam Clerk.
Atkins, yes. Ayers, yes. Bailey, yes. Baird, yes. Davis, yes. Evans, yes. Hall, yes. Hatmaker, yes. Nance, yes. Ward, yes. And White, yes.
Okay. Now I'll entertain a motion to approve the new applicants, of which we have three. Brandon Michael Lawson, Shayna Mundy, and Jennifer Hicks.
Motion to approve the new applicants, Mr. Chairman.
Motion by Rusty Oryx, seconded by Sue Nance, to approve the new applicants. Any questions, any discussion? All those in favor, vote yes, then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 11 yes, 4 absent. New applicants are approved. Call out the vote.
Atkins, yes. Ayers, yes. Bailey, yes. Baird, yes. Davis, yes. Evans, yes. Hall, yes. Hatmaker, yes. Nance, yes. Orrick, yes. And White, yes.
Okay. Moving on, I'll entertain a motion to approve the committee reports and minutes, including the ones in your packet that was passed out tonight.
Motion to approve, Mr. Chairman.
Got a motion by Oryx, seconded by Alvin Evans. Any questions? Any corrections? All those in favor of approving the committee reports and minutes, vote yes, then press your confirmed button. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Ruthford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Committee reports are approved. Okay, now we're down to budget amendments and funding resolutions. I'll entertain a motion to approve them.
Make a motion that we approve 11-1 through 11-19, I believe that's.
Have a motion to approve 11-1 through 11-19 by Commissioner Oryx, seconded by Wendell Bailey. Any questions, any discussion?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
Jeff, can you go over 11-18, please?
It's dealt with the ability to refinance the 5 years of the outstanding bond this year and total gross savings about $660,000 over the full 6 year period. And 5 years, 550 could be the net savings in our pockets from doing that. The first $100,000 worth of savings will go to pay for the cost of the reissue. That's what the budget amendment here deals with, is the reallocation of the rental fund bonds being saved to provide for the cost of the issue.
So the savings is how much?
$660 over 6 years, $110,000 per year, with a net $550.
How much longer? What's the difference in the current length of the bond payment?
No.
Same?
Same.
Some better interest rate.
Going from about 4.5 to 1.25.
You got anywhere for that savings to go?
Presently, no, they will allow us to not be in as much of a use of debt service fund balance and or to deal with some lost revenues on the interest rebates through sequestration at the federal level and or deal with any future revenue shortfalls from lack of growth. Give us an opportunity to deal with any revenue shortfalls and potentially maybe be able to borrow a short-term note if we stabilize.
So you're planning on putting that back into the county general?
No, it stays in debt service.
In debt service? Okay.
Any other questions? Ready to vote. All those in favor of approval of budget resolution 11-1 through 11-19, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am.
I need to state conflict of interest.
Sue Nance states a conflict of interest. David Adkins. Alvin Evans. Okay. 11 yes and 4 absent. Budget resolutions are approved. Next, we have to approve the resolution to for the refunding of the bond.
I make a motion that we approve. It's a reauthorizing resolution that we have.
Correct.
I'll second that.
It's located in the back of your packet. You have a motion by Orrick, seconded by Hatmaker. Anyone have any questions? Ready to vote. All those in favor of the reauthorization resolution, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Resolution is approved. Next, I will entertain a motion to approve the reports from county officials and departments.
Make a motion to approve the other reports and the other departments, official reports and other departments. Mr. Chairman.
Second. Got a motion by Orrick, seconded by Sue Nance, to approve the reports from county officials and all departments.
That's the ones that are in the packet.
Exactly.
They're not in the packet, they're not approved.
Exactly. Okay. Any questions? And the packet that was handed out tonight as well. Okay, all those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. The reports are approved. Okay, under other matters, we have entertain a motion to approve the 2000 Ford E450 Campbell 10 ambulance as surplus.
I make a motion to approve the surplus. Maybe Alvin, maybe we'll discuss that.
This is Campbell. This is not the.
No, it's the one we're doing.
We'll do this other one.
I'll still make that motion.
Second.
A remount for Campbell 10. No, Campbell 8 is being surplus to remount and be called Campbell 10. Okay, we've got a motion by Commissioner Orrick, seconded by Alvin Evans. Anybody have any questions? Okay, all those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Okay, we have request from Campbell County 911 to name a new road, Susan Lynn Lane, which is off of Cherry Bottom Road.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, sir.
Four motions made on that. Did that come from the board or did that come from the office?
It says, Campbell County 911 Mapping and Addressing Department requests County Commissioners' approval for a new road. Residents that reside on the long driveway off Cherry Bottom Road will have a 911 road name address change. They have given their approval for the change. The requested name for this road is Susan Lynn Lane.
The 911 board gave their approval? I'm sorry. I read it, but they've not had any minutes from the 911 board showing their approval.
Do you know whether or not that it was brought up to the board, Joe?
I'd rather wait, because every time we approve these, we approve them with their blessing.
Okay.
And myself, I'm not making a motion on this, but I would hope we'd wait till the board looks at it and says, well, it looks good for us, it's good enough for you all. And I'm not taking nothing from the people that's doing this job, but that's normally how it comes to us that I've seen. And I know it's your district, not trying to hold anything up. I'm sure there's nothing but
the county road, we know for sure it's county road.
It's the lane right there.
Let's be if there.
Is it a new road?
It's.
It says it's a long driveway.
If it's not a current county road,
it wouldn't be on the road. Unless it's not as something
no.
else, what was
it
before?
We just put it on the road.
I don't have any more information than what's in the pack.
Okay, motion to delay that till the next meeting till we get more information.
Okay, we got a motion.
Second or motion?
We got a motion and a second to table this until the December meeting.
911
meeting. Anybody have any questions about that? All those in favor of tabling this action from 911 till December, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Trust the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Motion is tabled. Alvin, at the EMS committee meeting tonight, there was an action that was taken to surplus a mini mod ambulance from North Regional Ambulance Service, and to use that the proceeds from that to fix the 4x4 ambulance that is presently over at North Regional.
Correct.
Would you like to make that motion? Does everyone understand the motion?
It'll bring the 4x4 ambulance in compliance with state
right.
regulations.
And what the Campbell County owns both ambulances.
They still stay there.
Yes.
Except for the surplus one.
Right. I need a second. We have a motion and a second. Anybody have any questions, any discussion? All those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Moving on. There's an entertaining motion to approve the amended resolution that was passed in December 20 of 2010 to put the courthouse maintenance supervisor under the control of the county mayor as far as hiring and firing.
Mr. Chairman.
With approval by the commission.
I'll make that motion.
Okay, we've got a motion from David Atkins, seconded by J.L. Davis. Any question, any discussion?
Good question. You make the nomination, it comes before the board.
The board either approves or denies.
Is that off two-thirds majority or super majority?
Simple majority.
Simple majority?
Okay. Any other questions? Trustee Ory.
We discussed this in length the other night. I know you was on vacation. But it still can come back to us if we decide later down the road.
It takes a simple majority.
It takes a simple majority to change it back. I don't know who this individual is. We don't know. But I want somebody to work. And I think that's pretty much all of us sitting here, somebody to do the job and stay with it. And I know 15 people. I wouldn't want 15 people as my boss. I would. I don't think I've ever told Mr. Dealback in the time I've been down here what to do. And I'm sure you all haven't either. And I know the mayor watches over the courthouse or something needs to be done, it's fine. But if that individual comes up to be just a person that don't want to do anything, I'll bring it up to terminate him, take the action back and to terminate. I think we need to get some people in here to work hard for us. And it's not going to be an easy job, not doing maintenance. But anyway, I'll be quiet.
You can't terminate.
We can if we take the power back.
Mm-hmm.
We can try.
That's true.
I've seen it done before. It usually ends up in a lawsuit, but that's where it ends up at.
Okay, any other questions? Marie?
I think it said you'll supply us with a job description somewhere.
Take it before the, take it before the insurance personnel committee. Provide them with a job description to approve. And then the applicants, if you wanted to see a resume, I would do that as well.
Kind of like we did with environmental?
Right.
I guess my question is not just job description, but we need to look at skills, requirements, license, etc. Because if you don't get somebody that's actually licensed in refrigeration, licensed in electrical, David said it the other night, how are you going to find somebody that can do all
that? That'll be part of the job description.
I read the correspondence between our attorney and CTS, and I guess that's really what swayed me on a lot of it. And I have no problem with you supervising. I think that's much better than 15 of us. But I guess what Marie's trying to say is we'd still like to have a party in. Because I said it the other night, we don't want just to be a position and us still farm out all this work.
Right.
And it cost us hundreds of thousands of dollars to get what we're paying somebody already to do.
That's the biggest fear I think we all have. That's the reason what we're doing.
Yeah. I understand that, but you know how things go.
Right.
I just know I've driven by a lot, and I've seen multiple people out here doing work that are not licensed. They don't have a business license. They don't have workers' comp. They don't have anything. I've not brought it up, but I'm saying if that's the stuff we're going to replace, we need to make sure they're licensed and do a good job.
I'm sorry. Did you ever get?
You're going to estimate the price of what we paying out here for maintenance of the courthouse. Just a general figure, because I know we contract a lot of it out.
Mr. Marlowe, are you?
On maintenance in the courthouse.
I didn't think you were.
On maintenance in the courthouse, do you have a number that we normally spend each year? Just because we contract a lot of stuff out.
I don't know,
you've got
a regular courthouse maintenance budget. There's not much contracting that goes on. It's mostly supplies and materials that you have the wages and benefits in there. We do have a small amount of money in there for like the maintenance associated with the elevator out here. That's a contract that we have. And we used to do a lot of business with Archer Heating and Air.
But if we have problems, I may have worded it wrong, if we have problems with ballast, we hire somebody. I'm sure we don't have nobody here doing maintenance replacing ballast.
In the regular courthouse, again, I don't think there's that much of that work that goes on. The sheriff has his own budget for that work. The career center has its own budget for that work. The biggest expense that we spend for what I'll call courthouse renovation work is out of the 171 category, capture project budget, and we appropriate $70,000 a year for that, and we will generally use most of that money. It'll be all kinds of different things. Maybe have to replace some concrete steps that have been solid, whether we're out or a door up at the back building, or different pieces of parts. But in grand total, I don't know, maybe you can put all the budget together, $100,000 a year. It'll be for car. It's not just for labor. That's for the materials, and might be able to replace carpet in this room. It'll come out of that 707 line item, or Monty that put in some carpets on the floor that came out of there for painting those on. So I don't think that there's a great amount of contract labor that would broke into something more than $25,000 to $35,000 a year would be my
guess. I was just kind of curious, I asked that the other night. And I know sometimes it's hard to come up with all those numbers at one time.
Marie?
One more. He mentioned the jail or the sheriff's department has their own portion for maintenance. I mean, ideally, that would go down, we would hope, by putting somebody in the position that can do it. So
one of the things that's been, I think, one of the things that has never made any sense to me since I've been here, Sue contested, she was here with Don a long time. The maintenance operations of the general courthouse maintenance have always just been limited to the courthouse proper. The jail always had to have its own. The health department always had to have its own. The career center had to have its own. The vet building had to have its own. On and on and on and on. And it never made any real sense to me why that would be done that way. And hopefully what y'all do here is to create a facilities, county facilities maintenance position where all that can be undertaken simply and not have everybody and their brother doing different things. That's the whole thing's got.
And that was one of my questions. Is it going to be for all the facilities or just the courthouse?
All the facilities.
They're going to have a full-time job.
Yes.
Well, it's going to be more than a full-time
job. Well, it is, but that's why I got to the point I got to.
Mr. Baird?
I think the thing that everybody's kind of getting at is having a maintenance schedule.
Right.
To see the things are, the builders are changed and that sort of thing. Before the unit powers up, grease or.
That's for Bobby. I got a question.
Bobby?
That's called the venue maintenance. Because once those filters stop up and you burn a, air conditioner up.
Right.
I mean, it's
too late to change.
It's too late to change the filter. And that needs to be on the schedule where they take your time.
Agreed.
David.
We've got the infrastructure, so to speak, to facilitate this position. I mean, he's going to have we've got a place to put him because he's going to have stuff that he builds up over time to repair and to replace. And
we have space that will be part of our infrastructure. We need some food for an office setting. Two buildings over here on the FDP lot.
Stores
of materials and stuff like that.
Right.
Yes.
Russ, to clarify one more thing, Jeff, this is money that's coming out of two positions that retired.
There are two vacant positions presently, a very barren position, a non-bill-based position. And depending upon what in the realm of health has to be had, not sure whether they'll end up being part-time position in addition to this position or some other position, but the goal is to use the funds to do it without more funds.
We'll see that coming.
And as Marie said a second ago, hopefully what we can do is trim the amount we will pay out for contract labor to increase the maintenance budget over time and decrease the money going out the door.
That's what I was getting at, just trying to cut the cost from one end to the other.
Sue Dance?
Back to Jerry Baird's position. Is that going to be filled, because he's actually not maintenance, he's considered
custodial.
So are you refilling that position?
No, depends on what we need.
Because now we have family custodians.
You've only got
two. And they do courthouse only?
Yes.
And then we have a contract for how many buildings? That building.
Finance, back, health, and careers.
And that's two contracts.
And the lady that the health department sues actually employed.
That does a contract?
No. She's actually a full-time assistant.
Oh, I got you.
Yeah.
She does that on the side.
And then the lady that cleans the real good.
No, she's
mine.
Full-time employees.
As a custodian?
A whole different person. I also, the person that cleans the bag and mine your building, they're a part-time employee.
Is it the same person?
It is, Meredith. And then there's a lady, Glenn McGuire's wife, Jeanette, has been a custodian at the health department for 15 years or longer. So there's actually three full-time custodian employees and one part-time custodian employee today, exclusive of the Jerry Baird position.
Okay. My question is, do we have to have another custodial worker in courthouse? You've only got two.
Well, there's probably going to be...
Because we're using this money now, you can't go back and reuse it.
One of the things we don't get notices is how much more demand the new space.
Right. The jail justice center is going to be...
I could say no for the two, if it were staying the same. But we don't know exactly what's going to come about with the new space and new courtroom space and stuff like that. Hopefully not, but if in fact we need more money, we'll get it from what Marie said in the savings of what we pay out the door in contract service.
Ready to vote. All those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Okay, moving on. Marie Ayers.
Mayor Baird, before you get into the recognition of the commissioners, what about the surplus?
Oh, that's right.
And the agreement for the buy board.
That's true.
I sent out to you all the information on the two trucks that the highway department wants to declare surplus. I'll entertain a motion.
Motion to approve the surplus.
Second. Got a motion by Horick, seconded by Wendell Bailey. They're both 2007 model Chevrolet dump trucks. Any questions? All those in favor of determining them as surplus, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change their vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. And I also emailed to you all today a cooperative buy board national purchasing cooperative agreement. The education department already uses, is already a member of this cooperative, and we need to suspend the rules to to take any action on this National Purchasing Cooperative. We got a motion by David Adkins, seconded by Rusty Orrick to suspend the rules. Any questions about that?
You want to go over it, Mayor, because I don't...
We will whenever we, after we suspend the rules. It's a, I'll let Jeff explain it. It's a...
It's just like a tip-tax thing.
Yeah, tip-tax, that's what I'm trying to think of.
You're a member of this cooperative, and they, the cooperative goes out and requests information about all these different types of supplies, equipment, and gets the lowest bid. And if we're a member of that cooperative, then we can take advantage of that without having to go through that process. Okay. We're ready to vote on the suspension of the rules. All those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Okay, now I'll entertain a motion to approve being a member of this cooperative group. Got a motion by David Adkins.
Second.
Seconded by Wendell Bailey. Any questions?
Is there a fee?
Yes.
Is there a fee?
No. As I understand it, the fee is paid by the vendors. Ready to vote. All those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Okay, now moving on. Marie Ayers.
It's in here somewhere.
Yeah. There's a formal resolution adopting the Jackson Law, and that's what she has put on the agenda.
Formal resolution for the Jackson Law. So I'll make a motion we approve the Jackson Law formally.
Second.
We have a motion and by Marie Ayers, seconded by Sue Nance to adopt the Jackson Law resolution. Any discussion, any questions? J.L. Davis.
This is the same law back from last time. It's just,
making a formal resolution.
Okay, let's go.
All those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent.
Mayor, before you move, somebody did notify TDEC. We will.
CPAS had thought that TDEC might want a formal resolution.
Sounds a little bit. Yes. For the sake of the audience, one went in already.
Right.
Because there was some question whether it ever gone in at all.
Right.
And it did. This is just one that he thought we should have heard. You got a copy?
Yes.
That's correct. One of the things when we were asking for this opinion that you all probably need to know, I asked CCAS just for future reference, just what's the real difference between a motion and a resolution as a practical purpose? And what they said to us is there really isn't any difference. That unless a statute requires that you take an action by a formal resolution, that a simple motion is okay. And in this instance, there was no such requirement. So, but we have that information now for future reference.
Okay. Rusty, do you want us to take action to request TDOT
Yeah, and I've got something else I'm going to bring up. I know I didn't put it on the agenda, but I'm going to make a motion to suspend the rules when we get done tonight.
I thought we already voted on it. We voted on it. Okay, Sue. Rusty, one.
What I brought up the other night, the light at Toe String, and I was kind of, one tells me it has to go through the city, one tells me it can go through from the county into the state for the red light to actually have, I mean, you're real familiar with it, Tom. You come out at Walgreens, you've got one turn back going toward Jacksboro, one light dedicated. The other light's dedicated goes straight across to CVS and to that subdivision. I'm wanting to ask them to move both of them turning with the outside lane, the right lane, also going forward. That way you get more traffic on the road without three or four. We need them to look at that. I think that would help a lot. I talked to Jim Mullins back a couple months back, and he thought it was a great idea.
It would also help if you turn both lanes turn into Jacksboro, which everybody does, but it's not marked.
Yeah, but if they had marked
them, turn them both to Jacksboro.
That's what he's talking about.
I thought you said straight. I'm sorry.
What is now?
The one that goes straight now, he wants it to say straight.
Straight and turn. That way they can go on to the subdivision, yeah. CVS and Medical Plaza. And those other two lanes, if they so see it, they can go on down. Yeah. We see it every day when we're out in bigger cities. But we need that.
The red light doesn't stay red or green long enough to begin with.
Well, the thing about it, and we discussed this the other day in Lent, they've tried it every way that they can try it. If they move it, hold it more on the four lane, it backs up. It's the best mix over years of trying. It's the best mix they can come up with. But with this idea, it will get more cars down the road if TDEC will approve it. I won't do that in a resolution. I make a motion that we send it to the state and requesting it. I'm not trying to get over top of LaFollette. If LaFollette wants to help on it, and I'd hope they would. But that's my motion that we...
Okay, does everyone understand?
Requesting a red light to be adjusted there for a turn and a straight.
And I'll second it since I'm the one that goes up the road and does a U-turn.
Adopt a resolution to request TDOT to designate both lanes coming out of Toe String onto State Route 9.
Get some more cars out.
Both lanes be designated as left turn lanes as well as straight.
Everybody understand what we're doing? Ready to vote. All those in favor, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no. Come on, Marie.
She's doing a U-turn.
Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Ruford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent.
The other thing I put on there was about the ATV law. Did you ever find out anything about it, Mayor?
No.
Can we get, have you, Joe?
We're in the process of researching that right now and getting some opinions on it. I have three different statutes that deal with it. There's a federal regulation that deals with it. I should have something for you on it next time.
I've had a lot of complaints, and being a rider myself, you know, they pass a law and they say that you can ride them, you can tag them. I think Debbie's been going through this, had the highway patrol come down and tell her to quit selling the tags. She has to by law. By state law, she has to sell them a tag if they want it. But she's been advising them that they're going to get ticketed. So I want to find out. If the state passed the law at the level, if they can permit these to be rode on the road, then that's what they need to do. And we don't have to take no action, just find out. But I want to suspend the rules, Mayor. And why I want to suspend the rules is about our driver's license place up here. I give you a little input on what I'm wanting to do.
Okay, we've got a motion to suspend the rules to take action concerning our driver's license office.
Second. I'll second.
We've got a second by David Atkins. Any discussion?
All those in favor of suspending the rules, vote yes. Those opposed, vote no.
Mr. Baird. You going to vote?
Yeah.
Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Rules are suspended.
My motion is that we do a resolution asking the state of Tennessee to bring our driver's license office back into place up here instead of where they sent it to in Clinton. I know we have enough business up for it up here. I know you are all hearing the complaints. And they happen to go down there and make their license in Clinton. They go down there and they sit all day. I can't see why they shut the building down. They didn't save no money. By what I'm hearing, they're still paying rent. Mm-hmm. Let's request them as a whole, whether it does any good or not. Let's try. People's been asking, won't know why.
Okay, we've got a motion. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Second by Marie Ayers. Any questions or any discussion? All those
in favor vote yes. Those opposed vote no. Anyone wish to change your vote? Show us the vote, ma'am. 11 yes, 4 absent. Johnny Bruce, Steve Rutherford, Terry Singley, and Bob Walden are absent. Motion is approved. Okay. Any announcements?
Everybody have a good Thanksgiving.
Tom Hatmaker.
Am I correct? We have an animal advisory board meeting tomorrow night. Just what someone told me yesterday.
Haven't received any information. Is it the third? No, the third Thursday already. Tuesday.
That's what Kathy Perry told me yesterday.
You do have.
We haven't sent out. We have gotten a notice. We haven't sent out a notice to any people.
I have one question. What? I seen in the FMS minutes that there was an emergency purchase to train for 2 rooftop HVAC units. What qualified that as an emergency?
Which are you talking about? Which 2 are you talking about?
Jacksboro Elementary.
That was, they had to have heat and air. It was school at Jacksboro Elementary.
How many units are on top of the school total?
I don't know. Total, I do not.
I'm just trying to think if it's something.
But the thing that you might notice, Tom, is the train done that, and it was used as an emergency purchase. But 6 months ago or 9 months ago, they put in a bid to do that, and the difference was only $2,000. Is that right, Jed?
That's correct.
So $4,000 more?
No, $2,000 more than what they had originally bid.
On
just
both,
$1,000
per year.
Longevity in the product or whatever. So it wasn't out of line.
Okay. That's why I was asking.
Yeah.
One more thing.
So.
Machines.
Yes.
Somebody taking care of those now?
Yes.
I've had complaints there's no coats now.
They just put them in there Wednesday, I guess.
Okay. So they're on top of them?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. We get the first
of them. Motion to adjourn.
Motion to hear second.
Second.
Well, baby, we are adjourned.
Precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows gray,
precious Lord, linger near, when my life is almost gone. Hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord. Disappears and the night draws near and the day is past and gone. At the river I stand, guide my feet, hold my hand. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me home, let me stand. I'm tired, I'm weak, I'm precious Lord.
And camp meetings went for weeks. Folks came from all around to hear him preach. Daddy said if one is saved, it's worth it all. But the aisles were always filled at altar call.
Daddy was an old-time preacher man. He preached the word of God throughout the land. He preached so plain a child could understand. Yes, Daddy was an old-time preacher man. Daddy worked for God but asked no pay. For he believed that God provides a way.
We never had a lot, but we got by.
I guess it's cause the Lord was on my daddy's side. Yes, Daddy was an old-time preacher man. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. I'm on my way to Canaan's land. Yes, Daddy was an old-time preacher man. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet. Oh,
Don't let me cross over love's cheating line. I'm tempted, my darling, to steal you away. So help me, my darling, stay out of my way. You know that I love, but I'm not the cheating kind. I'm faced with a heartache at love's cheating line. Don't let me cross over love's cheating line. You belong to another, and you'll never be mine. I know one step closer would be heaven divine. Don't let me cross over love's cheating line. I've tried to forget you, but what else can I do? When your eyes keep saying that you love me too, I know if I lose you, not a dream will I have left. I don't want to cheat, dear, but I can't help myself. Don't let me cross over love's cheating line. You belong to another, and you'll never be I know one step closer would be heaven divine. Don't let me cross over love's cheating line.
easy to